Today we celebrate the nativity, or as we say, the birthday of Saint John the Baptist. Normally, in the calendar of saints, we don't celebrate their birthdays because their birthday to this earth was not really the date when they started to grow in grace, but we rather usually celebrate as their feast days, the date of their death, namely when they were taken to the heavenly glory. We do celebrate, of course, our Lord's birthday, Christmas, because from that time he started his earthly wandering, becoming our Redeemer. And we celebrate also the birthday of a Blessed Virgin Mary, because she, as the greatest of God's creation, was every, from her first moments here on earth, a prime example to us how to act, how to think, and how to do. But we also celebrate the feast or the birthday of Saint John the Baptist. And reason for this is that Saint John the Baptist was sanctified in his mother's womb. So he was not conceived immaculately like Blessed Virgin Mary was, but at the visitation he was sanctified. And in this way, when he was born, he was already in the state of grace and never committed a sin in his life. So in this way, we celebrate the great feast of his birthday during summer, and then at the start of, or at the end part of the summer, we also celebrate his glorious death and martyrdom. The life of Saint John the Baptist is a great example to us, and especially for our young people. The young people should see from his birth that how greatly the and many sacrifices the parents do for their children. Saint Zachary and Saint Elizabeth, they had been barren, that is, without a child, for years and years to come. And that might have been the cause of despair or sadness to them. But so great was their faith to God Almighty that they never stopped praying and offering sacrifice to God Almighty, but they believed and trusted to his mercy. And eventually they did become parents. And what a way God did showed them mercy and favor by making them the parents of the precursor of our Lord. We also read from the birth of Saint Baptist how great proof his birth is of the divinity, that is the Godhead, of Jesus Christ. In the end of the Gospel, Zachary starts his canticle of praise and thanksgiving, and he gives testimony of the divinity of our dear Redeemer. Saint John was to be the prophet of the highest, and also to go before the face of the Lord. So this is Lord himself, Savior, Creator, and Redeemer of mankind, whom Saint John is meant to announce. So in that way, he is also an example to our young people in the spirit of humility, that whatever they do in their lives, they should always announce Christ, of course, both by their words and profession of faith, but also by their actions, so that children and young people always learn to stay far, far away from sin, and also to do good works, which are according to the charity and also to the commandments of God. Saint John the Baptist, he spent his youth leading a very holy life of a hermit in the desert. Saint John cared nothing about the great powers, the great praises or riches of the world, because he knew that very basic and good teaching of the church, but which we so often forget, that the glories, riches and the fames of this world, they mean absolutely nothing at the hour of your death. When you are called to your particular judgment, the one thing which matters, how you dealt with God Almighty, and not so much how you dealt with men. Were you good? Did you follow his commandments? Did you show kindness and charity as you should? Did you do your religious duties well? Did you do your Easter duty? Did you attend the holy sacrifice of the Mass on the day, on Sundays and holy days of obligation? If you did your duty as well as you possibly could, then God will be favorable to you on your day of judgment. But if you rather cared about pleasing the world, if you rather cared about your own desires and your own will, then you will find out that God will not give you a very desirable judgment on your particular judgment. So St. John was meant to be precursor of the Lord, who would herald him, preach to the people the need of penance and reparation for that life. And he prepared to this mission very well, just like our children are meant to prepare themselves in being the heralds, in being the doers of Christ's will in their lives. One of the main problems of our world is how to teach our children to do well, and how to teach them to always stay far away from evil. And the greatest way to do that is of showing a good example. I recently happened to read about an Irish man named Gene Tunney, who was a professional boxer in about 100 or 90 years ago in America. Those times were very rough for Irishmen, and one of their recreation was to watch boxing. And church never liked that too much, because it's such a violent sport, but she tolerated that so that not to cause too much stir in the minds of the faithful. In any case, Gene Tunney was a rough man who had been a Marine, but his parents had also raised him very well, always to be mindful and careful about sin. It happened to him, namely to Tunney, not long after he had won some grand, great prize in boxing, that many of his friends got together and gave him a big banquet in honor of this great new achievement. And after the grand meal, there started a show, a kind of floor show, but which was not very nice kind of floor show, and in fact was an impure show. The Gene Tunney, his parents had raised him to fear God and obey commandments, so this champion, he did not like the show. In fact, he was angry. He stood up at the speaker's table and said, "Gentlemen, I don't care for this type of show. I find it indecent and offensive. You'll have to excuse me." And every eye was glued on him when he reached for his hat and quickly left the room, leaving behind all his friends having a big ball in his honor. And since the guest of honor had left, others did the same, and before long there was nobody left, and the indecent show stopped. This was a kind of a achievement and a very great act of Gene Tunney. He was quite a fighter, but not so much, we don't appreciate him as much as a fighter in the ring, but as a fighter, as a Catholic. He had been a Marine in the World War I, and he had received many, many medals for his bravery in battle. and then he won many fierce fights in the boxing ring, but he never fought a braver fight and won a greater victory than on that night when he, in front of all his friends as a guest of honor, stood up, objected the indecent show, just took his hat and left. What a great bravery it took. But it also shows that if we make an act of the will always to follow the rules and commandments of a God, then God also gives us grace always to act according to his will, even if we should receive strange looks or even mockery from the people. St. John the Baptist, most of the people to whom he preached, they thought he was crazy. He dressed funny, ate strange food, went out from the desert, gave fire and brimstone sermons about God's wrath and upcoming judgment and your need of doing reparation and penance. He was considered a joke, a fool, or by some people even a dangerous one. But he preached the will of God. And if you say and tell the other people the will of God, they often get offended. And when you actually do the will of God and you do follow his commandments, then oftentimes people get very angry to you. And this is kind of a acid test of every Catholic, is when it's a question about the popularity among people and then being good in the eyes of God. Which one do we choose? Do we teach to our children to look after the will of God and the place in heaven? Or do we rather, either by our words or by example, teach them that what matters is that you do well in this world? All these kind of questions should come into your mind when you listen and study the life of St. John the Baptist. So St. John, he came into the world in a state of grace, but even he grew daily in grace and virtue. We, on the other hand, we come into this world in the state of original sin, but through baptism, we are not made children of this world anymore, but instead made children of God. So how do we answer to this dignity of being a child of God, which is truly the greatest dignity one can ever have, far above any sports star or politician or being even the president of the United States? If president of the United States would do his office badly, he would face immediate and does face immediate amounts of mockery, saying how lousy and bad he is. But if a Christian, if a Catholic chooses to do his own will in the world, most of the time people just applaud to him. But we don't want the applauds or good words from the people of this world. We want to live in the state of grace, and we want also to do and follow the will of God in our lives. I always tell our school children that it is not enough just to believe what God and Church says. You must also to act according to will of God and act according to the rules of Church. St. John the Baptist, he was born in the state of grace, but he also lived and acted like a follower of God and acted like a person in the state of grace. And this is a daily job for all of us Catholics. We must daily examine our conscience to check, kind of in the form of the checklist, that have we kept the commandments today? And have we shown to other people that the same spirit of forgiveness and charity as God has shown to us? Or have we rather seek to do our own will, and have we also then let the other people know that as well, what our will is. So life of Saint John the Baptist is a good way of doing an examination of conscience, but it's also the great the reminder of the endless mercy of God Almighty. If God would not have cared about the poor sinners of the world, he would never have sent Saint John the Baptist to preach penance and repentance of to them. And of course, had God chosen to abandon mankind to their sins, he would never have let our blessed Redeemer Jesus to be born. When we think both and when we remember both the justice and mercy of God, that's the only way how we can keep our life clean, pure, and brave, even in the face of mockery or in the face of persecution. Lives of the saints are an endless treasury and endless teaching to us, and we should often meditate them. And when we, like Saint John the Baptist, we are born into this world, and we, like all the saints before us, we also shall die one day. If we do the will of God, we have no fears about eternal punishment, no fears of the flames of hell. The bad things and the grand judgment is reserved for evil people of the world. And if we humble ourselves, if we do penance, and if we do love God more than anything else in the world, then as Saint John the Baptist and all the saints before us, we will truly be remembered by God as well, and we will be taken to his heavenly kingdom instead of the place of everlasting punishment. May God bless you. In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Ghost. Amen.